Last class, we completed to discuss about Adi Shankara. Children, today we move on to discuss about the Ramanuja. Ramanuja, he was the 11th century Vaishnava saint. 11th century is Vaishnava saint. He was the 11th century Vaishnava saint, and also he was the most influential thinker of Vaishnavism. He was the most influential thinker of Vaishnavism, and also his philosophy was known as Visishtadvaita. His philosophy was known as Visishtadvaita. Visishtadvaita. He was the 11th century Vaishnava saint, and also he was most influenced with the thinker of Vaishnavism, and his philosophy was known as Visishtadvaita. His philosophy proclaims that the soul retains his identity even after attaining with Brahma. This is a main proclaims of his philosophy. After a devotional pilgrimage, Ramanuja's after completing the devotional pilgrimage, after completing his devotional pilgrimage, he settled in Srirangam. He was settled in Srirangam. And then he expressed his ideas towards the social equality. He expressed his ideas and thoughts towards the social equality. And also he restricted the caste-based entering into the temple. Nowadays also this system can be followed. Caste-based entering into the temples. He restricted the caste-based entering into the temples. His devotional to Lord Vishnu and his consort Lakshmi is called Sri Vaishnavism. What? His devotion to Lord and Lord Vishnu and his consort Lakshmi is called as Sri Vaishnavism. And then, so he established many centers to spread his doctrines. So, because of Sri Vaishnavism, he established many centers to spread his doctrines about the Lord Krishna and his consort Lakshmi. Then, in 16th and 17th century, Vaishnavism spread all over across the India. During the 17th and 16th century. And then Vadagalai Vaishnavism originally flourished around the Kanchipuram. Vadagalai Vaishnavism can be flourished in the Kanchipuram. Next thing, which was popular in Kanchipuram, it was a popular center of learning Sanskrit. It was famous for learning Sanskrit center. And then Tengalai Vaishnavism was centered on Srirangam. Vadagalai sect focused on Vedic literature. And then it was written in Sanskrit language. It was written in Sanskrit language. Vadagalai Vaishnavism can be populated by center of learning Sanskrit. It was well known for the Vedic literature and it was written in the language of Sanskrit. But Tengalai Vaishnavism can be the centered of Srirangam. And it was it stressed the importance for Divya Prabandham. It was written by 12 Ahalwars. We already discussed about the Ahalwars. Divya Prabandham was written by 12 Ahalwars. Those 12 Ahalwars was a Tamil poetics. So Divya Prabandham is the language of Tamil. These are about the Ramanuja. Next we move on to the Bhakti movement. Bhakti movement in North India. Bhakti movement in, already we see the beginning stage of Bhakti movement. Today we are going to discuss about the Bhakti movement in North India. Before discussing the Bhakti movement, we have to know 14th and 15th century. 14th and 15th century, the religious movement in Northern India. Everyone has to remind that two different attitudes which Hindu religious leaders had towards Islam. Hindu religious people had some restriction towards Islam. That is, one group accepted Islam. What are the best in Islam? And another group, they try to avoid the people who are going to change the Islam. The second group, they try to avoid the people who are going to change the Islamic culture. These are restrictions of the Hindu towards the Islam. And then both groups reacted to the Islam. But both the two groups reacted to the Islam. But one was in the way of sympathetic. One reacted the way of sympathetic and then another group reacted the way of hostile. These are the various between two groups. Here, Kabir and Guru Nanak are other founders under the first group. Kabir and Guru Nanak. Kabir and Guru Nanak was the one of the founders of first group. The Bhakti movement in Bengal. Bhakti movement in Bengal, including with Chaitanya Deva. Bhakti movement in Bengal, including the Chaitanya Deva, or otherwise he was called as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu belongs to the second group. Kabir and Guru Nanak belongs to the one of the founder of first group. And then here, during the Bhakti movement in Bengal, Chaitanya Deva, or otherwise he was called as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he belongs to the second group. These are about the Bhakti movement in North India. Next, we move on to the exponents of Bhakti movement. What? Exponents. exponents of bhakti movement. Here Ramananda. Who? Ramananda spread the bhakti movement. It finally becomes the mass movement in North India. Ramananda spread the bhakti movement. Finally, it became the mass movement in North India. Telugu philosopher Vallabhacharya. He was one of the Telugu philosopher Vallabhacharya. He was the Telugu philosopher. He built a temple for Lord Krishna near Madura. He built the temple for Lord Krishna near Madura. And then Sardas. It was one of the exponents. Ramananda and next one Vallabhacharya. Next we go to Surdas. He was a blind poet. He didn't know the eye power. So he was one of the blind poet. And also he was one of the musician. Not only he was a poet, he was also the musician. Blind poet and musician. Had a link between this Lord Krishna temple to the Agra temple. Sardas, a blind poet and musician, had a link between the temple who built for the Lord Krishna and also the temple to Agra. His famous collection. Surdas' famous collections of poetry was called as Sursahar. His famous collection of poetry was called as Sursahar. First one, we see about the exponents of Ramananda, and then second thing Vallabhacharya, and about Surdas. Here next we move on to the Mirabai. She was the wife of Mewar dynasty's crown prince. He was the wife of Mewar dynasty's crown prince. She was a devotee of Lord Krishna. Mirabai, she was a devotee of Lord Krishna. And also he was a disciple of Ravidas. He was a disciple in the sense Sishyai of Ravidas. One thing, he was a devotee of Lord Krishna, and then other thing, she was a disciple of Ravidas. And then third one, she became very popularity through her bhajanai. In olden days, we all know bhajanai is a famous one. Through his bhajanai, Mirabai became a very popular one. These are about the Mirabai. Next, Chaitanya Deva. Next, we move on about the Chaitanya Deva. Chaitanya Deva. He was popularized the devotion of Lord Krishna with his songs and dancing. He was very popularized with his Lord Krishna's songs and dance. It creates the profound effect of Vaishnavism in Bengal. Through the songs and dance, it creates the various effect about the Vaishnavism in Bengal. It is one of the mentioned thing. In 16th century, Tulasidas wrote a story about Ramar. In Hindi, in the language of Hindi. In 16th century, Tulasidas wrote a story about the Ramar in the language of Hindi. Later the same story about Rama can be retelling in the work of Ramacharitamanas. Ramcharitamanas. After the same Tulasidas story was retelling in the story of Ramcharitamas. It was in the language of Tamil. And also through this story, it gives more importance for friendship. And also it speaks about the loyalty. Nowadays also some of these songs are used to sung in the nighttime celebration. These are the exponents of Bhakti movement, and then we move on to the Sufism in India. The period of Arab conquesting Sindh. Sufism entered into the India. Sufism becomes popular during the 10th and 11th century. It becomes very popular during the 10th and 11th century, which was under the power of Delhi Sultan. The period of Arab conquesting Sindh, it was the time to enter in the Sufism in India. During the century of 10th and 11th century, it was very popular. At the time, Delhi Sultan was ruled. Also, Sufism adopts the yoga, music and dance. Sufism also adopts the yoga, music and dance. Then, both Hindus and Muslims are the followers of Sufism. Muslims and Hindu are the followers of Sufism. Next thing, in medieval India, Sufis were divided into three major orders. Sufis was divided into three major orders. Sisti. First one, Sisti. Second thing, Suravardi. First one, Sisti. Next thing, Suravardi. Next one, Firdausi. These are the three major orders of Sufism. Sisti, Suravardi, Firdausi. Here, Moinuddin Sisti made Sisti to become popular in India. Moinuddin Sisti made the Sisti popularity in India. And then Moinuddin Sisti died in Ajmer. He was one of the famous famous philosopher. He died in Ajmer at 1236. He died at the Ajmer. He was buried in Ajmer Sharif Dargah, Ajmer Sharif दरगाह, अजमेर शरीफ दरगाह इन अजमेर एंड राजस्थान. सफीज निजामुद्दीन औलिया आर द टू पर्सन्स फ्रॉम सिस्टी ऑर्डर ड्यूरिंग द मेडिवल पीरियड. अदर देन मेनुद्दीन देयर इज सम टू पर्सन्स सुफी एंड निजामुद्दीन. Sufi and Nizamuddin Ali Aulia are the Christian order during the medieval period. A large number of ruling classes can follow their way in Jhelgi. A lot of persons can be followed their way in Jhelgi. Amir Husru, he was one of a great poet, belongs to the follower of Sisti order under the Sufis under Nizamuddin. Amir Husru. He was one of the great poet. He followed the way of Sufis in Sisti order. Next thing we discuss about the Sisti. Next we move on to the Suravardi. Suravardi order was founded by an Ibrahim Sufi Abdul Wahid Abu Najib. It was a name, Ibrahim Sufi Abul Wahid Abu Nazib. He was the founder of Suravardi. And then next thing about Firdausi. Firdausi was one of the branch of Suravardi. It was one of the branch of Suravardi. It was one of the branch of Suravardi. Suravardi order. It was confined only at Bihar. These are about the Firdausi. Thank you, children.